We're now at the point where we can discuss the dimension of a subspace, which we're going to see is closely related to the rank of a matrix. Bases are not unique. We talked about a basis of a subspace. Every non-trivial subspace of Rm has a basis. We saw that we can just keep adding vectors to a spanning set until that spanning set spans the subspace. This basis is not unique. For example, you can simply take the vectors in the basis and multiply them by a non-zero constant and construct a new basis. However, it is the case that the number of vectors in a basis for a given subspace is always the same. And that number we call the dimension of the subspace. A theorem. Let's let S be a subspace of Rm. And let's say that we have two bases for S. And one of those bases has n vectors in it, and the other basis has k vectors in it. We're going to prove that k is equal to n. In other words, no matter what basis you pick for S, it always has the same number of vectors in it. Proof by contradiction. Okay, let me just quickly walk you through it. So what's the proof? Well, let's assume that there are more vectors W than there are vectors V. We can create matrices that have those vectors as their columns. That's our slicing and dicing. Now, we know that the columns of V span this subspace, and since each W is in the subspace, for each of those W's, we can find a vector that tells you how to take linear combinations of the columns of V to generate that vector. We can then take all of those X's and make them into a matrix. It looks like this. But notice that X has to be n by k. Why is that? The number of columns in V is n, so the size of each vector X is n. And the number of W's was k, and therefore we must have k of these vectors x. But notice now that x is therefore n by k, and this is greater than that. What does that mean? Anytime you have fewer rows than you have columns, there is a vector y in the null space of this matrix. Therefore, we have a non-zero y, such that x times y is 0, but w times y is then equal to that, is equal to that, is equal to that, is equal to that. But what does that mean? That means w has a non-zero vector in its null space, and that inherently means that these vectors cannot be linearly independent, and that contradicts the fact that those vectors form a basis for S. And that's what's summarized here. So the bottom line is that the dimension of the subspace S is simply defined to be the number of vectors in any basis for that subspace. For subspaces, we have now defined what the dimension of a subspace is. It is the number of vectors in the basis. The column space of A is a subspace, so the dimension of that subspace is the number of vectors in the basis. This is often called the rank of matrix A. So the rank of matrix A equals the number of vectors in the basis for the column space of A, which is the same as the number of linearly independent columns that matrix A has. If A has n linearly independent columns, then its rank is equal to n, and then A is often said to be a full rank. This is important. Matrix A is invertible only if its rank is equal to n. In other words, only if it has n linearly independent columns. But then we had sort of seen that already right there.